English?
Probably in English, but yes. Better not in Italian or German maybe.
No, English.
My Italian is not too good. Francesco, just christened the boat. Very emotional moment for you. I mean,
of course, every time is very emotional when you christen a new boat.
Yeah.
And this is a special boat. For sure, it's not a conservative approach to the design. You guys have seen it. It's quite aggressive, and I hope it's gonna be fast as well.
It looks a little similar to the Kiwi boat with the ballot. Yeah. Under that, what's the idea behind it?
Well, obviously, you can have the design is quite free, and we came to similar conclusion with the Kiwis. Unfortunately, yes, the bulb under the boat is not so much a bulb because it's not heavy. It's part of the hull shape, and it's so obviously that when you take off, you have less wetted surface, so it's less drag, and so should help on the takeoff phase.
At what speed would you take off? What do you say?
Somewhere between 16 and 20 knots, depending on the conditions,
that's
depending on the
speed.
Weight, boat speed, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So what is wind speed then?
Wind speed is going to be between 7 and 10 knots.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
Above 10, for sure, you are up and going.
So it's kind of mass sailing, isn't it?
Yes,
congratulations. Haven't you been European champion?
Yes, this year, yes.
Yeah,
I'm sailing the moth a lot, and it's quite propedeutic for what I'm doing now here, and I'm learning a lot and I'm having a lot of fun, so the moth is a great boat.
So it's also about not splashing down with the moth.
Of course,
it's the same.
It's very all the basic concepts are the same. Absolutely.
So what do you think about driving this beast? I mean, is there, of course, you're one of the driver of the potential drivers. Will you do it, or will there be? There's James Biddle, of course. You have the Nacro 70 guy
who is
really world champion.
Yes.
Ruggero
Tita.
Ruggero.
Yes.
You have some really young guys
sailors,
in the team. How will it be the decision?
Well, I think the as we always said, the boat is going to decide who is going to be on it, and that is going to be the case again. I think we have to just work so that the boat goes as fast as possible, and whoever deserves to be in the boat is going to be in the boat.
So do you have some competition on the simulator? I mean, sailing against each other?
Yes, it's great.
Like an esports kid.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. We are kids again.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like being kids again. The simulator is great. It's great fun.
Yeah.
We spend a lot of hours neat trying to give the best feedback as possible to the designers, but now it's time to the real boat.
So how are you doing so far as a helmsman? I mean,
competition, good.
Is it really like you run a Formula One simulator and then you have the seconds and then say, okay, I'm faster today?
No, it's not like that, because there are so, it's not just one driver.
Yeah.
As you know, it's a teamwork. It's a wing trimmer, foil trimmer, and there are so many components who makes the result. So it's not a net result like with a laser, one design boat, you win, you are the best. It's not as straightforward. Yes.
I mean, personally, in America's Cup, you didn't have the best timing before. I mean, you were with Azzurra, and then it didn't work out. Then you were with Luna Rossa, and then we all know about it.
The last Cup. Yeah.
Now you're at the top spot.
Yes, I think Luna Rossa is on the front line, and let's hope that the boat is fast and reliable.
I wish you good luck.
Thank you
so
much.
And we're going to follow it.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Bye.
Francesco.
Ciao.